Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be answering a question that was asked on Yahoo Answers, where someone asks how they can model this interlocking, these two interlocking arches in a 3D modeling software. We're going to use SketchUp, obviously, and we're going to jump into that after the intro. All right, so I've opened SketchUp, and the first thing I'm going to start with is just modeling a rectangle, and then we're going to hit C for circle. I don't have any dimensions, so I'm just going to eyeball it. When I hit C, you can see size down here. I've set to 60. By default, SketchUp sets that at 24, so you may want to increase that. I'm going to delete some of these extra lines. I need to make a vertical line here. I'm just going to make half to start. So there we go, we have half of our arch. Then I'm gonna choose the offset tool and offset my shape. Now the tricky thing with offsetting curves is that then how do you complete this curve? So I'm gonna show you a little trick on how you can do that. This is straight, so it's pretty simple. Delete those two lines, select my arch. Now the thing that's cool, it's like a nice thing about SketchUp is that it uses segments. And all of those edges are the same size. So what I can do is select this, hit Control to make a copy. I don't know if this got cut off or not, so I'm just gonna select here, hit Q for the rotate tool. And if I don't make a copy, it's gonna pull everything with it. So I'm just gonna hit Control to make a copy and select that line. And you can see it finishes my arc. I'm just gonna delete these extra things. You can always use E as well, the eraser tool. Delete this, and we have half of our arc. I'm going to take this, copy it to the side, right click on it, hit rotate, flip along, green axis, delete here. So there you go. Now we have a center point. And let's just assume that halfway down. So we're going to go all the way down. I just drew that line for no reason. And let's say, I don't know how thick we want to make this. Let's say it's 2 inches. So we'll do an inch on this side. And then come back 2 inches, go all the way up, just overextend to make sure that we are extending. So let's make our group at this point before we extrude. So we'll take this and then we'll make a copy of it below. We'll just extend this down, delete, there we go. And then extrude this 2 inches. That way I have both shapes and I don't have to worry about like refilling in that shape. Like that, 2 inches. That's a group. Take this, hit Q for rotate. Rotate 90 degrees. Select it. Now these should be at the same point. There you go. So we have our arch piece, and they're slotted into each other. So if you look at this really quick, this guy can fit down into that guy and it should stand up. So hopefully this helped. If you thought this video was helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.